I just wrote this sentence. Let's read it out loud. Bang, what was that? James, Sarah and Layla woke up. It sounds a bit strange. I think there's something missing. Ah, I know. Punctuation. Punctuation helps us know how to read sentences. So instead of bang, what was that? James, Sarah and Layla woke up, I'm going to add some punctuation. So the sentence now reads, bang, what was that? James, Sarah and Layla woke up. Wow, that is much better. Wow, that is much better. Here are five different types of punctuation. Capital letters, full stops, commas, exclamation marks, and question marks. Capital letters are bigger than lowercase letters, and they go at the start of sentences. They're used for other things as well, such as names of people and places, days of the week, months of the year, and whenever we refer to ourselves as I. Capital letters can also be used to make words sound loud, like bang, crash, and wow. Full stops, sometimes known as periods, go at the end of sentences. Without full stops, sentences would just merge into each other and sound very strange. For example, the cat was sleeping, she looked very cozy in her bed, it was nearly time for her dinner. Now let's add the full stops and read the sentences again. The cat was sleeping, she looked very cozy in her bed, it was nearly time for her dinner. That sounds much better, because the full stops separate each sentence nicely and make them easier to read. Remember, we also need to make sure each sentence begins with a capital letter. Like that. Perfect. Commas go in the middle of a sentence and tell us when to take a short pause. They can be used to separate words in a list, like, I need to buy milk, cheese, bread, and apples. You might have noticed that there's no comma after bread. That's because we use the word and to separate the last two items in a list, so many people leave out the comma. Some people do choose to write a comma before and though, and this is known as an Oxford or serial comma. Commas can also be used to separate parts of a sentence, like, when Cherry sat on the sofa, her feet didn't touch the floor. Did you know that commas can completely change the meaning of a sentence? If I wrote, let's see Grandma, she'd be scared that I'm serving her up for dinner. But if I put a comma in there, instead it says, let's see Grandma, and she can relax, because I'm just inviting her to dinner instead. Exclamation marks go at the end of sentences like full stops, but they're used to add emphasis. For example, the castle was huge. That sentence makes sense, but we can make it sound more exciting by adding an exclamation mark at the end. The castle was huge! They can also be used to show when someone is shouting. It's the difference between come over here and come over here! Question marks go at the end of questions, like when does the show start? What is the nearest train station? And who wrote Winnie the Pooh? If you're not sure if a sentence is a question, check if it can have an answer. When does the show start? 7 p.m. What is the nearest train station? London Paddington. Who wrote Winnie the Pooh? A.A. Milne. Okay, so we've got capital letters, full stops, commas, exclamation marks, and question marks. Let's play a game. I'm going to show you a sentence with one type of punctuation missing, and I want you to work out which one it is. Where are you going on holiday? If you want, you can pause the video to give yourself more time. Question mark. This sentence is a question, so it needs to have a question mark at the end. When I play basketball, I play with Jaya and Charlie. Capital letters. We need one at the start of the sentence, at the start of Jaya and Charlie, and both I's need to be capital as well. My favourite animals are giraffes, lions, elephants, and rhinos. Commas. This sentence includes a list, so we need to put a comma after giraffes and a comma after lions. Okay, so let's quickly remind ourselves of the types of punctuation again. Capital letters are used for the start of sentences, names, and I. Full stops go at the end of sentences. Commas go in the middle of sentences to separate words in a list or parts of a sentence. Exclamation marks go at the end of sentences and add emphasis. And question marks go at the end of questions. Let's play another game. I'm going to write out some sentences without any punctuation, and I want you to work out what's missing and where to put it. It will be cold on Friday, so I bought some new gloves. If you want, you can pause the video and do it all by yourself, or keep watching and I'll do it with you. Okay, I can't see a full stop, so let's add that in. It will be cold on Friday, and so I bought some new gloves, don't sound right without a pause in between. So let's put a comma in the middle and separate them into two parts. I also can't see any capital letters. Firstly, we need to add one at the start of the sentence. Then Friday needs a capital letter as well, because it's a day of the week. Finally, I've also referred to myself as I, so that needs a capital letter too. It will be cold on Friday, so I bought some new gloves. Yep, that sounds right. Okay, let's write out another sentence. When are we eating dinner? I am so hungry. Okay, so when are we eating dinner and I am so hungry sound like separate sentences. When are we eating dinner is a question, so let's put a question mark at the end. We could put a full stop at the end of I am so hungry, but that would be a bit boring. Let's add an exclamation mark instead to emphasize how hungry I am. Finally, we need to add capital letters at the start of both sentences. When are we eating dinner? I am so hungry. Wonderful. Let's write out one more sentence. My favorite cities are London, Paris, Sydney, and Pisa. I love to travel. Okay, so I love to travel and everything before that feel like two different sentences. So let's first put a full stop after Pisa. We could also put a full stop after travel, but an exclamation mark will help emphasize how much I love to travel. Now let's look at capital letters. My and I need capital letters because they're at the start of each sentence. London, Paris, Sydney, and Pisa are all place names, so they need a capital letter each as well. Finally, because the first sentence includes a list of words, we need to add in some commas. So let's put one after London and one after Paris. My favorite cities are London, Paris, Sydney, and Pisa. I love to travel. Great, I think that sounds perfect. Okay, so let's quickly remind ourselves of the types of punctuation one more time. Capital letters are used for the start of sentences, names, and I. Full stops go at the end of sentences. Commas go in the middle of sentences to separate words in a list or parts of a sentence. Exclamation marks go at the end of sentences and add emphasis. And question marks go at the end of questions. If you want to keep practicing, download the worksheet in the video description. Here are some really unusual punctuation marks. What's your favourite? Tell me in the comments below. If you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to learn more science, English, and maths with Will, and let me know what you want to learn next by commenting below or emailing info@learnwithwill.co.uk.